to Earth from space. Today, the Copernicus Sentinel-1b satellite takes us over Semara in northeast Ethiopia. Semara is a new town with a population of just over 2,600 and serves as the capital of the Afar region. The region spans an estimated 270,000 square kilometres from close to the border with Eritrea towards the capital of Addis Ababa. We can see the regional capital in the top right of this false colour image, with the larger urban centre of Dubti just south of the town. Both are found in the Great Rift Valley, which lies between the Ethiopian Plateau and the Somalia Plateau. The landscape of the Afar region is characterised by desert shrubland and volcanoes, particularly in the north. In this image, we can see differences in altitude represented in the variations in colour. The left part of the image is dominated by yellow, signifying changes in vegetation found at higher altitudes. Two lakes, Hike Lake and Hadibo Lake, are shown in the bottom left. South of Dubti, we can see the Awash River, which flows into the northern salt lakes rather than into the sea. Salt trade is typical of the area, whilst cotton is grown in the Awash River Valley. Maize, beans, papaya and bananas are also cultivated in the Afar region. It is thought that 90% of the region's population lead a pastoral life, rearing animals such as camels, sheep and donkeys. Dalol, to the north of Semara in Ethiopia's Danakil Depression, is frequently cited as one of the hottest inhabited places on Earth. Lying 125 metres below sea level, with temperatures in the spectacular hydrothermal fields averaging around 34.4 degrees Celsius year-round, and the area receiving just 100 to 200 millimetres of rainfall a year, conditions are thought to be amongst the most inhospitable in the world. Sentinel-1b was launched in April 2016, carrying an advanced radar instrument to provide an all-weather, day and night supply of imagery of Earth's surface. Along with Sentinel-1A, which was launched in April 2014, the mission benefits numerous services, including monitoring land surface for motion risks and mapping to support crisis situations. That brings us to the end of this week's edition of Earth from Space. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week.